moving on.
To weekly vlogs. Basically, there was an incident maybe like 2-3 weeks ago. I was at the Sainsbury's on Camberwell Road and I was just shopping, like just browsing, just looking at the bakery section. Basically, the Sainsbury's manager, he came up to me. He tapped me on my back. I thought these times, to alert someone like that, you must be thinking, oh, they've dropped the wallet or something. But this guy literally spun around and said, oh, you smell like weed. I just thought I'd let you know. I had a shower that morning. I've never, ever, ever, ever smoked in my life. So these times I was thinking, what, is this you've been framed, some stupid joke? I asked the Donnie again, he said, no, I thought you smelled like weed. I just thought you'd like to know. Long story cut short, I posted a tweet, which I'll link right there. Sainsbury's got back to me, we've been in discourse since. So now I'm about to give the store a call, because he says that the manager wants to personally extend his apology to me in person. So, got my phone now. Basically, there was an incident at the store, like maybe 2-3 weeks ago.
George, yes. Yes, George, I do know you. I am embarrassed and apologetic, okay, and I am genuinely mortified about my lack of judgment that day. I really am. So I really hope that you can accept my apology. I've got a little bit more to say about my reasons why I said what I said and did it, and hopefully you might understand a little bit better, but I should never have put you in a situation where I made you feel uncomfortable and embarrassed the way I did. So I really apologise about that. About 5 minutes before you came in the store, I just chased the shoplifter out of the store, and I have just phoned the police, and the police were on their way to come and see me. At the point that you walked into the store, I got a whiff of weed, and I looked up and I saw that you were the only person in my vision, and I thought it must have been you, and I honestly wanted to just give some warning that the police were on their way. And I wasn't thinking straight. I thought it must have been you. As soon as I said it to you, I was close to you, and I realised by your reaction and by the fact that I put myself in the shoes of whoever it was. Now, it might have been somebody that walked past me that wasn't in my vision. I suppose it could have been a smell that had come from outside in at that time. And as soon as I spoke to you and I saw your reaction and I couldn't smell it, I was mortified. As soon as the race card came out, I just wanted to get myself the hell out of that situation. I didn't know how to react, because in my head there was absolutely nothing trying to be racist or make you feel like that. Now, I understand that if I put myself in your shoes, somebody comes out, a white guy comes up to you and accuses you of smoking weed and you don't know any of the background, I can understand how you could feel like that. So I've been reflecting and trying to think how that came about, and I get it, but it seriously wasn't on my radar. I mean, most of the customers and most of the colleagues and customers in my shop at that time were black. I don't expect you to think that it was right, because it wasn't. I shouldn't have made you feel like that, but that's what happened in my head anyway.
I can see what angle that you're coming from, but I just feel that literally as a manager you should have thought one step ahead, just in regards, yeah, just in regards to potentially offending anyone.
I'm genuinely sorry. You know, I have to make judgment calls every day, every single day at work, and there'll be difficult situations where I have to make a call on shoplifters, RAMA and things like that, but for something like this, I just shouldn't have done it. And I get that. I absolutely get that. I don't think that, even if I was 100% sure that any individual did smell of something illegal or whatever it might be, it's not my right to say anything. And I certainly shouldn't be making people feel uncomfortable in my shop. So I get that, Jordan. I appreciate that you've given me the opportunity to sort of explain myself. I know it doesn't cut it, George. I know it doesn't. It does make it right. I completely get that, but I hope. I mean, the one thing that I hope is that you can sort of understand that I didn't. However, it came across, that wasn't my intention.
Another day on the left. I woke up this morning and figured I call you. Election day. Who'll win, Trump, Clinton, whatever. We'll see. If it's gonna be anything like the Brexit, hold tight. Trouble in my life. I'm fortunate you believe in a dream. This often just came back from the library. Mildly productive day. I've been offered a trial shift for delivery, but I have no back. I haven't had a back in years. But obviously, I just said I did. I'd like to announce myself as the ambassador for Chicago Town. This is the stuff that gets you through uni. You need to find this. I'm deal for £1 like I've just bought. Buy like 5 or 6, there's 2 in a packet, that's like 10 or 12. Get yourself a bag of chips. Bob's your uncle, there's some quick food for you. I remember being here, what, like 8 years ago, in the living room, watching Barack Obama win. And I remember thinking to myself, like, no matter what this guy goes on to do, it's like I actually feel like genuinely inspired, like to see a black man become the president of somewhere like America. When I compare all the feelings I felt then to what I feel now, and it's just like, they're two villains. I feel like George Bush, who I'd never side with ordinarily, when he voted for neither, I mean, I know some people are supporting Trump, but I was gonna stay up, but hopefully I go to bed and it's not like Brexit, where you'll wake up and you see it's a madness. Sure. I'm gonna let you congratulations, Trump. Then it's my turn to settle down. My main concern, promise that you will sing about me. Promise that you will. Today is the 10th of November 2016. So right now, just on the way to the library. To settle down, my main concern, promise that you will sing about me. Promise that you will sing about me. I said when the light shut off, then it's my turn to settle down. My main concern, promise that you will. Oh my days, fam. They drop this music on a regular basis, you know. 2016, it needs to stop, fam. When Master was having a wahaka just now, she found a toothpick.
Yeah, George saw me. I was biting into it and he's like, huh? So it was like that.
So we managed to get some discounts off our meal. I can't remember the name of the woman who just left the apprentice.
Some of the blonde ones.
Yeah, but we saw her in Oaxaca store. Ensuring that my allegiance with the other side may come soon. And if I'm doomed, may the wound of my mother be blessed for many moons. I suffer a lot. And every day that glass mirror get tough for the watch. I tie my stomach in knots. And I'm not sure why I'm infatuated with death. My imagination is surely an aggravation of threats that can come about. Cause the tongue is mighty powerful, and I can name a list of your favorites that probably vouch. Maybe cause I'm a dreamer and sleep is the cousin of death. Really stuck in the schema, wondering when I'ma rest. And you're right, your brother was a brother to me. And your sister's situation was the one that put me in a direction to speak on something that's realer than the TV screen. By any means, wasn't trying to hold Finn to come between her personal life. I was like, you need to be told. Cursing the life of 20 generations at the hurt soul. Exactly what'd happen if I ain't continue rapping or steady being distracted by money, drugs, and 4-5s. I count lives all on these songs. Look at the weak and cry. Pray one day you be strong, fighting for your rights, even when you're wrong. And hope that at least one of you think about me when I'm gone.
Chat shit, I'm gonna stand firm in it. No, seriously, like, if you got a message and you got a purpose,
I just went to Young Gold Talks at Google Campus. Yeah, we got Billy Banks.
Peppercorn, please.
Sunday, 13th. November, who's currently running late for church. Alright, alongside, say hello, you know, it's our birthday soon, we're born 2 days apart, so we'll be celebrating that soon. We're currently just waiting for my mum to get back. Anna's just pointed out to me that that is a creature drinking to a prison. I've noticed it before, you know. I spent like 36 hours editing that video and I didn't realise
that. What the hell is that?
It's 20 to 12. Still got this video to create, but yeah, I must say I'm enjoying this whole process, though it does make me think how on earth I'm gonna do this daily. But that is my challenge to see. It's been lovely seeing my sister today. Must send out my condolences on this Remembrance Sunday to those 7 people who died in a corroding tram crash. I've got another interview lined up with waitress for a store opening up.
Did that take too long? I need to stop procrastinating and listening to music. Don't watch any of that music on there. It's my personal taste. I don't care. But yeah, hopefully you guys have
a great week. It's been lovely going to the Gold Talks, just catching up with people, just talking, meeting new people. Thanks for watching this. Share it. Subscribe if you want. I'll see you on the next vlog.
I never knew Casey Nice that was an ambassador for Chicago Town Pizza as well, you know. I like it.